Harry Connick Jr. has been a frequent guest on our program, and with each visit, it seems he comes with more to talk about. He's currently on a national tour with his band and awaiting the October release of his next film called Little Man Tate. He's also just released another big band album, thank you. This one's titled Blue Light, Red Light. Where you at?
Home slice.
How you been?
Fine, all man. Good? Everything's great.
You haven't been spending much time at home, though.
Not too much. We've been traveling and recording, and I'm kind of glad that we've had the opportunity to keep busy in a way.
Yeah. It seems like I have known you, my goodness, for as long as I've been doing this show. I mean, you've been out there for a long time now. Has the plan gone pretty much as you thought it would, or has it surprised you?
A few things have been surprising. I mean, I never thought I'd have a band like this, so that's one great surprise. But otherwise, it's something that I've always wanted to do. It was just a question of how and when I was going to do it. So mixed in with the plan were a few great surprises.
But you started out as kind of like a jazz man and a cabaret singer, and now suddenly you're a big band leader and you're an actor. That wasn't part of the grand plan, was it?
Well, I think the music was the major plan, and under that umbrella come a lot of different sort of opportunities and vehicles, movies being one of them, because in both of the films that I've done, I did a little bit of music, and so I think that's what got me in there, you know? It's kind of the thing with movies, I think everybody in a way would like to see themselves on the big screen, and I'm no different, and I had the opportunity, so I was certainly going to employ it when it came around.
You're going to come back another time. We're going to talk about Little Man Tate, so let's talk about music
today.
Why the big band sound? Why are you going back to that? I see back to it in terms of the progression of American music.
Right. Well, for me, it's the most challenging type of music. You're dealing with, in this particular band, 17 musicians. I have to write the arrangements and deal with the group concept. And for me, it's the most challenging type of music to play. I've dabbled in other kinds of music, and I think I know a little bit about different kinds of music. And I think big band is the most exciting and challenging and wonderful music around.
Bands aren't supposed to be a democracy, but are you terribly authoritarian with this group? Don't look at them. You're signing their paychecks.
I was asking them for their answer, man.
Yes,
it's
no?
Democracy at work. Yeah.
Somewhat authoritarian?
I'm very democratic, right?
Yeah, right.
We have a nice relationship.
Do you?
See, I think if everybody in the band had his own band, they would run it their way, and I have to have it my way, and I think that everyone understands that, and hopefully it doesn't go too far out of their musical boundaries, you know?
I was teasing earlier. I said, these guys are out of uniform, but you tell me these guys get the rhythm section gets to have its own uniform, right?
That's right. Well, I've been a part of a rhythm section, being the piano player for my whole life, so I have a special feeling in my heart for the rhythm section. However, Ben Wolf chooses to wear black. He wants to sort of hang with the band today, so they can wear what they want.
All right, I'm going to get out of here. You're going to play the title track?
That's right.
Title song from the album. Let me get out of here.
All right. Ready, God?
With room for a couple of cinders and a mouse, a hole and a trap. I don't worry about the flies or count the stairs, cause I know someone's there. I just lie and sweep in the dry, dusting after somebody else. Seeing that there's green on the windows, convincing the snow to melt. I don't worry about the ride or the subway fare, cause I know someone's there. One day we'll move uptown or even out through the countryside. And for every leaf on a tree, we'll add one cup to the fire. Who cares if the floor ain't level or if the ceiling falls in? Haunted by the devil or ghosts and boogeymen. I can't be concerned, why should I care? No place I go alone would compare, cause I know you're there. Thank you. uptown or even out to the countryside. And for every leaf on a tree, we'll add one cup to the prize. Who cares if the floor ain't level or if the ceiling falls in? Haunted by the devil or ghosts and boogeymen, I can't be concerned. Why should I care? No place I'd go alone would compare. 'Cause I know you're there.
Harry Connick Jr. We're back in just a moment after a break. This is Today on NBC.